secret passage.
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Boy, over here.
Huh, interesting. I may want to write that down. The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Well, that's the legend. You want it sense, you shouldn't be talking to a sever. Head. Doesn't fall far.
Yes, sir. I'm confused. I always heard that Baldur's mother was Frigg.
Aye, Frigg. Well, that's more of a pet name, you see. It means beloved, something Odin called Freya after they wed. Out of affection at first, or so I like to believe. As things turned sour, it became a way to manipulate the truth.
How so?
Odin didn't want Freya, a Vanir goddess, getting credit for anything in Asgard. So anything worthy she accomplished was attributed to Frigg.
Like being Baldur's mother.
That's right. Freya was Baldur's mother all along.
You boys look right beat.
They found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
Something else we can do for you?
Nah, just... glad you guys worked it out.
Ah. Well, I could say the same to you.
Ha!
I guess I was getting a bit full of myself.
Told him what he needed to hear, how's it sounds to me.
Just the same. I'm sorry for how I spoke to you, Sindri. You forgive me?
Already have. Like you said, it all worked out. Now, let us get back to work before I get...
sentimental.
Scafetta. That ought to keep them from hacking bits off you. Yes, that worked out.